Welcome back to Proactive, where I'm delighted to be joined once again by Ian Campbell. He's the CEO of Neural Therapeutics, and we've got plenty to talk about here today, Ian. We've been hearing from you quite a bit recently, but first things first, how are you getting on over there?
I'm doing well. It's a pleasure to see you again, Thomas.
Yeah, it's been good, hasn't it? We've been really focusing a lot on neural therapeutics. It's a fascinating mission that you're on there, and I'd like to start today by just asking what it is that you're trying to achieve with the business.
Well, with the business, we're trying to achieve the development of a medicine that can change the lives of many people. There's many people that are affected by mental illness, and we're trying to develop a drug which has been used for millennia and proven quite safe. But we're doing it in a different way than what others would be doing, because we believe there's a benefit to looking at it holistically.
So we've got a focus on mescaline specifically, and we're trying to harness the power of this natural medicine, as you conceive of it, in order to help people. And obviously, there's a business involved as well. So presumably, that must be quite a tough thing to try and monetize.
It can be, yes. And certainly, there's many hurdles to go through with the approvals from regulators like the FDA. But, you know, one has to chart a course and then also live it. And that's why I surrounded myself with such great team members of my board and advisors. And I've done a deep dive into the science of mescaline. We'll call it mescaline for now, but it's really more than just mescaline. It's actually an extract with other chemicals or alkaloids, which are natural to the plant. That actually, you might see one behind me actually here. And it's the San Pedro plant. And you know, nature evolved these chemicals for a reason. And rather than just focusing on the one, which we traditionally do in the pharmaceutical industry, or even in a lot of different industries, focusing on the suite of other chemicals that come along with that plant, as it was designed in nature, it was designed to be consumed, as it has been for thousands of years. It's kind of like throwing the baby out with the bathwater if we don't look at what else is there. I kind of look at it, Thomas. Sorry, I kind of look at it like the idea of what we did with wheat. You know, when we look at we basically beat wheat until we got the little part that we wanted, and then found out, you know, half a century later that really it would be better if we went if we looked at the whole wheat. There's a lot of other things that are involved in that, and nature makes things this way.
It's an absolutely fascinating thing to be working on, obviously, Ian, but it wasn't always your calling in life, was it? You've come to this after having a career elsewhere. So what was it that made you sort of change track in your life like this?
Oh, that's a deep and great question. Thank you. So, you know, things start for a reason in terms of like education. You start off on one path and then you grow into others. And for me, education has been a continuous curve. And I started off in doing physical sciences, moved into biology and into toxicology, then went into hard sciences and engineering in terms of how my career developed. Working in scientific instrumentation and managing engineering companies and automation companies, doing robotics, et cetera. But bringing it back to full circle was the toxicology part, where I always longed to develop something that would be beneficial for humankind. You know, when you go to business school, and actually when you live the turnaround business scenario, you look at how do I get the most of my team? How do I get everybody to get up in the morning and to be excited about what we're doing and what their mission is? It's great to have those words on a wall, but if people don't believe in them, then they won't actually live it. So you start off with, you know, mapping values, for example. This is one way that I've learned to do it, mapping the values and then creating a mission. And so I did that for myself at one point in time. I sat back for a few weeks and I thought, okay, well, what do I really want to achieve in this second half of my life? And map the values that were important to me. And for those reasons, I found myself fascinated by this field, being able to do something that was scientific, do something that could disrupt you know, technology as we know it and business. And then also to be able to do something for humankind, to be able to give back and something that would be well suited for my family. And that, those were the four things that that drives me every day.
Now, you have mentioned your family there, obviously, Ian. Be interesting to get a sense of how they felt about this change of tack from you, because obviously it did take a fair amount of courage, I'm sure.
Yes. You know, I sat on the opportunity for a little while, and then I discussed it with my family and got a thumbs up from them. You know, I think that with the realization that you can't escape, you know, mental illness issues today, you know, everybody, I don't care whether you have it directly or indirectly, you will be affected by mental health issues. And my family certainly is not exclusive of that either. We've all had that these issues, and I have their permission to actually, you know, give that that little bit of information. That it is actually motivating for me to see that I can do something for my immediate family and for other people I love too.
All understood, Ian. We appreciate that. So, where are you going to be taking this business next? You know, we've got a bit of a sense of the vision from you, but what are you currently engaged in day to day?
So we're currently engaged in the, you know, the development of the drug that we want to take into trials. We want to take it and see if we can get it somewhat fast tracked through the process of into human clinical trials. There's an awful lot of evidence that demonstrates that mescaline is, you know, has a high efficacy, and has also been has demonstrated significant benefits for different mental ailments that we are targeting. So we have an unusual path, being that we are going to be working with natural products. The pharmaceutical industry traditionally does not like that, doesn't really lend itself that way, although there is a shifting movement towards botanicals, and I think that they understand that. And you know, after looking at what's happened in the recent years, and even in this recent week, there's been some big news in psychedelics. So I think that there's a lot of momentum behind us, and taking it forward into human trials and proving that we can do what we already know we can do is the goal. And then simply have a product that will be distributed by clinicians and tech and doctors, et cetera, therapists for use is our goal.
Just finally, Ian, it's clear from talking to you that you are very serious about this and you have put a lot of thought into it. So I would like to know if you have, during your consideration of this project, defined for yourself what ultimate success would look like and obviously what ultimate failure would look like. Do you have a certain minimum deliverable that you're attempting to achieve during this second half of your life?
That's another great question, Thomas. I think that you know, success in life comes through not accepting the failures, but actually keeping in motion and moving forward. There's going to be many steps along the road where we'll hit bumps, but I think the experience that I have of managing various companies and turnarounds and go-to-market strategies, et cetera, are a benefit to this team. And that's what we're going to drive. We're going to drive this to success. And success for me will be to see our product being delivered to humans.
Let me wish you the very best of luck, very sincerely, Ian. Thank you very much indeed for your time, and we'll catch you again very soon, I'm sure.
Thank you, Thomas.